नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज डायरेक्टर जनरल अंडर कंपटीशन एक्ट 2002 ए स्टैट्यूटरी अथॉरिटी। द कंपटीशन एक्ट प्रोवाइड्स दैट द डायरेक्टर जनरल व्हेन सो डायरेक्टेड बाय द कमीशन इज टू असिस्ट द कमीशन इन इन्वेस्टिगेशन इनटू एनी कॉन्ट्रावेंशन ऑफ द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द एक्ट। द डायरेक्टर जनरल इज बाउंड टू कंप्लाई विद सच अ डायरेक्शन टू रेंडर रिक्विजाइट असिस्टेंस टू द कमीशन। The Director General, in order to effectively discharge his function, has been given the same powers as are conferred upon the Commission under Section 36, Subclause 2. Under Section 36, Subclause 2, the Commission is having same powers as are vested in Civil Code under the Code of Civil Procedure 1908, while trying a suit in respect of the following matters, namely, summon and enforcing the attendance of any person and examining both on oath, requiring the discovery and production of documents, receiving evidence on affidavits, issuing commission for the examination of witness or documents, subject to the provisions of Section 123 and 124 of the Indian Evidence Act 1872, requisitioning any public record or document or copy of such record or document from any office. Without prejudice to the above powers, the provision of Section 240 and 248 of the Companies Act 1956, so far as may be, shall apply to an investigation made by the Director General or by a person authorized by him, as they apply to an inspector under the Companies Act 1956, this power includes search and seizure of the record of any person in respect of which an investigation has been directed by the Commission. It has been provided that wherever the approval of the central government is required, the same shall be given by the Commission. Section 2 W defines the term statutory authority to come within the definition of the expression statutory authority shall be fulfilled. The authority shall be a board, corporation, council, institute, university or any other body corporate. It should have been established by or under any state or central or provincial act. It should have been so established for the purpose of regulating production or supply of goods or provision of any service or market, therefore, and it should have been established at least for any matter indicated therewith or incidental thereto. Section 19(1)(b) speak that the intention of inquiry, initiation of inquiry pursuant to a reference made to the commissioner by a statutory authority. Section 21 provides that where in the course of a proceeding before any statutory authority, an issue of raised by the party that any decision which such statutory authority has taken or purpose to take is or would be contrary to any of provision of the Act. The High Court further held that the statutory authority contemplated in Section 21A is one from whom to the Commission itself can seek an opinion. The Director General under the Act is not competent to give any opinion except concluding an investigation and assisting the Commission in the inquiry initiated under Section 19. Therefore, Section 19(1)(b) may have to the read and understood in the context of Section 21 and 21A of the Act. It will be very clear that the word statutory authority found in Section 91B, 21 and 21A cannot include the Director General. Another reason for this conclusion, the High Court held that the proviso to Section 21 subclause 1 empowers a statutory authority to make a reference suo motu to the Commission, but the Director General is not empowered to initiate an investigation suo motu.